Rabbi, when we requested this hearing, we asked to focus on anti-Semitism. But I just want to ask you if, in fact, anti-Semitic conduct and behavior is tolerated on college campuses or in our society in general, does that make it more likely that other religious or ethnic groups will also be treated in a similar abusive manner?
Thank you, Senator, for the question. Absolutely. Again, Jews are often called the canary in the coal mine of intolerance. What starts with the Jews never ends with the Jews. And it hasn't taken long already for the public cries from death to the Jews to become death to America and burning flags on our campuses as well.
So if this sort of behavior is tolerated, it's a threat to all minority groups.
It's a threat to our entire democracy, Senator.
Well, I want to talk specifically about the problems that some of the university presidents had in condemning anti-Semitism and enforcing their own rules against demonstrations on campus and the like. Harvard, University of California, Berkeley, Columbia, the University of Pennsylvania, NYU, and Carnegie Mellon apparently all had difficulties drawing the line between permissible speech and impermissible conduct. But one university seems to stand out, and I'm proud of the fact the University of Texas, when this happened on campus, that a number of people not even affiliated with the university threatened to occupy the buildings at the campus and ignored officials' continued pleas for restraint to immediately disperse. The university actually enforced its own rules. And is that the difference between what we saw in so many other places, that they simply tolerated this conduct and the University of Texas did not by enforcing its own rules?
In short, yes. Senator, there has been a complete abdication of authority when it comes to the First Amendment, and university presidents and law school deans that unabashedly explain that the First Amendment is hard to understand and they can't possibly enforce its limits don't belong running universities or law schools. The First Amendment is not a free pass to threaten, harass, intimidate, or otherwise violate the rights of others. There are limits to what constitutes speech, and there are rules for when it crosses over into actionable conduct. And if you can see those rules when it applies to racist, sexist, homophobic, misogynistic speech, but not when it comes to anti-Semitic speech, your problem is not with that line. Your problem is with anti-Semitism.
So normalizing this sort of anti-Semitism and the behavior that has been tolerated at so many of these universities is a threat to our society as a whole, specifically minorities. But if you see university leadership like that at the University of Texas actually enforcing its rules and taking action, that can help define what the community standards are and help protect all minorities, correct?
Absolutely.
So I was intrigued by what you were discussing in terms of foreign countries contributing significant sums of money to colleges and universities and perhaps that having some influence on their policies. We have something called the Foreign Agent Registration Act, which Senator Grassley and others of us have been trying to reform, because we know that foreign countries actively hire lobbyists here in Washington, D.C. to lobby members of Congress on legislation without members of Congress's knowledge that they are actually not up, they're functioning on part of foreign governments and not on behalf of their constituents, the American people. Could you explain a little bit more about the nature of that challenge, and do you support legislation that would tighten the disclosure requirements in particular so that we could know that foreign governments are actually the prime actors and funders of this activity as opposed to some American?
I absolutely support such legislation, and I will tell you that the problem actually goes further. You see, on campuses across the country, I don't know if any of the senators have spent time inside any of these encampments or protests. I have. And if you walk to the center, you'll notice something fascinating, which is that charitably, 20% of the people there know what river and what sea. Most of them are there for the pizza or because they have been genuinely misled into thinking that they are on the right side of history. And that is important because not only do they not know what they're doing, they don't know that they're actually in bed with terrorists. And that's why, again, our group, along with our partners at Greenberg Traurig, Holtzman Vogel, and others, brought the lawsuit against National Students for Justice in Palestine to try and help draw the line. Because maybe if we could expose that, maybe the 80% would walk away from the 20% of extremists, and we'd save 80% of our citizens, of our future congressmen, senators, and presidents. And so it's a deeply problematic issue that sometimes even the unfortunate useful idiots are not aware of.